Hello and welcome to this episode of Denny's Tips, where you'll be learning an awesome new trick on how to dehaze your photo with way better results. The dehaze adjustment in the camera raw filter helps reduce haze and restore the contrast in your photo, but a lot of times, it just doesn't look that great. In this tutorial, I'll show you how you can trick Photoshop into giving you better results with the dehaze adjustment. When Adobe released the Dehaze adjustment, everyone was amazed with the amount of details that it can restore. It's easy to use and it works quite well, but if you push the settings too high, you'll get a lot of color artifacts, and worst of all, you'll get this ugly glowing halo effect around the high contrast areas. Recently, I did a video review on a Photoshop alternative called Affinity Photo, and I found out that their Dehaze tool gave better results and it looked way more natural than Photoshop. And it looked more natural because there was just less halos overall. Halo effects are typically caused when you're doing something like luminosity masking and you blur the mask. The reason people blur the mask is to improve the details and clarity. Photoshop uses a very large blur radius for their dehaze tool, which makes the transition more gradual and safer. But as a result, you can sometimes get these huge halo effects around the high contrast areas. So I had a thought. Can you trick Photoshop into using a lower radius setting to get rid of the halos? The answer is yes, and it's surprisingly easy. Alright, here's how to perform the trick. Start by pressing Ctrl or Command J to duplicate the layer. Before we apply the dehaze filter, go to Image, Canvas Size. Set the width and height to 200% or larger. I usually like to start off with 400%. The larger your document size is, the less halos you'll see. Now that our document size is larger, we can use the dehaze tool. You can find this by going to Filter, Camera Raw Filter. If you get an error saying that your document is too large for the Camera Raw Filter, then undo, go back to the Canvas Size tool, and use a lower setting. The Camera Raw filter can only process around 500 megapixels. In the Camera Raw filter, go to the Effects tab and then adjust the dehaze setting. I'll set mine to the strongest setting so that you can see the results easier. Click OK to apply the changes. Keep in mind that your document size is huge, it's several times larger than the original size, so it might take a while to process. But once it's done, you can crop it back down to the proper size. A quick way to do this is to go to Image, Trim. The default settings are fine, so just click OK and it'll automatically trim your document back to the proper size. Congratulations! You just learned how to trick Photoshop into getting better results out of the dehaze adjustment. As you can see, the results look so much better even though we're maxing out the settings. There's not really any noticeable halos and there's less color artifacts. So if next time you or someone you know can't get good results over the dehaze adjustment, then try this trick out. Hey, thanks for watching this video. I hope you found that useful. By the way, I'm working on some Photoshop actions that will make this dehazing process so much easier. So if you're interested in that, subscribe to my channel and I'll let you know right away when the product is done. Aside from that, I wish you an awesome day and I'll see you again with another video next week.